Hi there. In this module, we're going to talk about the Embedded Studio debug terminal and real-time transfer. This typical evaluation code example uses the debug terminal to display output from the target with Segger's real-time transfer module, RTT for short. Traditional debug via terminal window uses a device UART connection to transfer data to or from the target. This approach works fine, but is not ideal as it consumes some target pens and resources. Printf via semi-hosting or SWO improves on this, moving the terminal feature into the debugger, utilizing the debug logic instead. With RTT, it is possible to send and receive data at higher speeds than semi-hosting or SWO without impacting the real-time behavior of the application. These files contain the associated code for implementing RTT. By default, Embedded Studio evaluation projects are configured to use the real-time transfer module, so it is immediately ready for developers to take advantage of. The Embedded Studio packages also come with the associated code ready to use. The printfs are redirected to the RTT buffer, then picked up by the connected JLink and directly displayed in the debug terminal. Again, this is not using a UART or a SWO connection, just a JLink and a defined memory block on the target. More information on the RTT feature is on the Segger website here. RTT is supported on Cortex-M and Renesas RX devices. On targets which do not support RTT, debug output to the Embedded Studio debug terminal can be performed using standard semi-hosting. Thanks for watching.